Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this part, we want to challenge ourselves and take a test to review what we have learned so far. We have 10 three-choice questions from previous sessions. Please read each one carefully and write down the correct answer for yourself. Pause the video if the question time is short. Finally, we will examine the correct answers together. And you can also find the correct answers in the description. Please write your score in the comment section and share it with others. For UI, React Native gives you special components which are then compiled to native use. For example, in React Native, we use view tag, which acts like div tag in HTML and actually compiles into native widgets on Android and iOS. Expo is a third-party service which is completely free to use. You don't need to sign up to get started, and you don't have to pay to build an app. In the terminal of Expo project, run this command npm run eject to turn it into React Native CLI project. We can use the default VS Code prettier to format the code by pressing Alt, Shift, and F keys. This helps make the code more readable. We use the text component to display the text. In the text component of React Native, the text to be displayed must be between two text tags. We import the useState hook from React. It lets us keep local state in a function component. The style names and values usually match how CSS works on the web, except names are written using camel casing, e.g. background color rather than background dash color. Flexbox is a concept of styling properties that allows you to structure content and design to provide a consistent layout on different screen sizes. Unlike browser, mobile apps don't give you automatic scrolling. ScrollView component adds it. Using ScrollViews in large arrays will cause you problems, because every time we display the list in it, the whole list is loaded at once, but the flat list only renders items that require to be displayed. Well, I hope you got a good result. Please write your score in the comment section and share it with others. To make your learning process faster, please do the practices at the end of the sessions and don't miss the quizzes to review what we have learned. See you soon at the next session.